It is 10:16 p.m. on Sunday, September 17th, 2017. It is only 6 more days before that beautiful, amazing, wonderful blessing in the atmosphere. And I decided to make one more video. But first, and I know I haven't did this yet, and please forgive me for it, but I'm going to pray first. Jesus, please guide my words, Holy Spirit, what I'm about to tell them. And Lord, please protect me as I sleep tonight. I know you're there, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. What I'm about to tell you may scare some people, and no, it was not a nightmare. This happened when I was actually living on my own on Rosecrans in Vermont in an apartment right next to 7-Eleven. I almost got hit by a gas 18-wheeler truck several times. I would sometimes come home late and I would hear a gas truck, 18-wheeler gas truck, and I would totally have nightmares. And one night during my nightmare, I woke up and I decided to go into the ladies' room. And I heard the 18-wheeler gas truck. It scared the living daylights out of me. I wasn't living a life in the Bible back then, and I wasn't living in the love of Christ. I decided to go outside, and I look in the parking lot where 7-Eleven is, because I was right next door, and I see that 18-wheeler gas truck. I ran back in. I was not living right at the time. And there was one night I actually came home kind of late. And I looked down the street and where I was walking, the 18-wheeler gas truck was coming that way. And I was right by my apartment and I ran in. Satan and his demons tried to take me out of this world several times. There was another time I was crossing the street and something told me to look up real fast, and it was a van that ran the light, and I got out of the way real fast. See, at the time, I wasn't living right. At the time, I did not confess any of my sins. I did not ask God the Father, Son, Jesus to come into my life. And I kept having those nightmares for a long time. Satan and his demons would attack me during Halloween. That's why Halloween is not my favorite. And I don't even celebrate Halloween because it's Satan and his demons night. So I was living a life of sin back then, having intercourse with men. And one of my ex-boyfriends, who will be nameless, went with me to a doctor's appointment, and we just got off a tour bus. And we were walking to the parking lot because at the time my doctor's office was right there at the Llama Mall. And this is a true story. I don't know if he wants to remember this because he was with me. But a bus tried to run us down several times. And we were together and we went apart real fast. And we got to a safety area. I didn't have to go into the doctor's office right away, and I was afraid to move. And I don't blame him, he was too. The scary part about it, nobody was driving. Nobody was driving that bus. And when the bus stopped and it went into another area at the Llama Mall parking lot, that's when we hurried into the building. And we decided to go out the other way after my doctor's appointment was done. We never talked about it. And it wasn't a dream. It was reality. It was a nightmare reality. It was just totally scary. And when I had that wake-up call that Wednesday night, Thursday morning in October when it was really, really freezing, that's when I decided to confess all my sins to the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. And that's when I became brand new. I wasn't all the way brand new yet. I was still living a sin life. Like, one leg was on this earth and the other leg was in heaven. And I finally realized I can't do that. And I'm hurting the only person that truly love me, so I completely stop the sin life. I'm not perfect, I never will be perfect, but I confess and I promise Jesus that I wouldn't have sex anymore until I'm married. And lately I noticed I haven't been cussing like I did. I haven't been lying like I did. I haven't been stealing like I did in the past. I actually confessed the stealing part to my mom. And I have been changing very slowly. But I know that I'm coming closer and closer to God the Father and God the Son and the Holy Spirit. I know He's inside of me. I don't get those nightmares like I do. Satan and his demons have attacked me lately. I did have those dreams like about 10 years ago about how the 18-wheeler truck was going to hit my mother's house. And it actually became reality, but it wasn't my mom's house. It was another house. I heard about it on the news. So I am so grateful and so thankful that God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit really is helping me, and really I'm letting Him change me, and I'm more and more in putting my feet on heaven's door, because there's nothing on this earth that really interests me anymore. And I know this is my testimony, and I really do pray that it will really help somebody out there. I'm putting it on my Google and my Facebook, and it will be on my YouTube too. So, lately I noticed I haven't been listening to little songs I really like. Even though I have my songs on Facebook, I'm more into the Watchmen videos, Barry Garman videos, Melissa Midnight Hour videos, Pastor Paul Bailey videos. I noticed I'm changing more and more now. I told the truth when I said I cannot read or write really, really good. That's why I have the Bible on my cell phone. And I take my Bible out when I have my Bible on my cell phone and making sure what I read and what I listen to that are the same thing, because I love the old-fashioned King James Version. So, I wanted to let you know that, yes, this really did happen. And, how I'm still here. And how there were times I could have died. Especially on that October night, I came really, really close to it. That was 9.5 years ago. I really do pray this video helped, and I want to thank you for watching this video, and I want to tell you to have, since this world has different time spots, and in London, California, it is nighttime, is the pointy past 10 p.m. I wanted to say have a blessed night and have blessed dreams and have a blessed morning, have blessed dreams, have a blessed evening, have blessed dreams, and have a blessed afternoon and have blessed dreams. I thank you again for watching my video, and I pray that my testimony does help somebody out there.